Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace, blessings, and mercy of God be upon you. This is another presentation from www.central-mosque.com and from the Humble Heart YouTube channel about the upcoming start of Ramadan 1441. When will Ramadan start and why? So, as you know, the format of these presentations on this channel, we will be succinct, to the point, and as brief as we possibly can. Before we talk about the subject at hand, at this time, there are many people around the world who are under lockdown or some kind of restrictions because of COVID-19. It is sunnah in Islam to try to sight the moon for Ramadan. But please stay safe, keep the social distance, and follow all the technical and the professional guidelines wherever you happen to be. And may Allah Ta'ala keep you, your family, your friends, your loved ones, and everyone safe. Ameen. When it comes to the start of Islamic months, it is very simple. In Islam, all 12 months depend upon the sighting of the moon, not the presence of the moon, but the sighting of the moon. So on the 29th of each month, you go outside, you try to sight the moon. If the moon is sighted, then the next month starts immediately after sunset. If the new moon is not sighted, then you complete 30 days and the new month starts the next day, and it's done all over whichever country you happen to be in, and local moon sighting is followed. So for example, if you live in London and you go to visit someone in Karachi, then you will follow the declarations of the Islamic scholars and their practices and their announcements and so on in Pakistan. You would not call London and try to follow their moon sighting or their prayer times or whatever. You will simply do it wherever you happen to be. Then on the way back, let's imagine that you stop at Johannesburg for 15 days. So while you're on Johannesburg, you will no longer follow Karachi. You will not follow London. You will follow the scholars of South Africa. When you come back to London, you'll start following the scholars of United Kingdom. When you go to Saudi Arabia, you will without a doubt follow Hajj Umrah dates of Saudi Arabia according to the scholars of Saudi Arabia without question. But when you're outside of Saudi Arabia, it is the declaration and it is the intent, it is the fatwa of the Saudi scholars, it will be in the description of this video, that you follow your local moon sighting. When it comes to Saudi Arabia, there is no 12-month moon sighting in Saudi Arabia. For most of the year, for up to 9 months out of the year, they follow a predetermined Ummul Qura astronomy-based calendar, which is based on faulty science. What Saudi Arabia do within their country and their domain is their business. They've never told anybody. In fact, they've told Muslims the opposite, that if you live elsewhere, follow your local moon sighting. So there's no rhyme or reason for Muslims living in the West, whether you are in Africa or Europe or Americas, South, Central or North America, to follow Saudi Arabia for whatever reason. There's simply no reason for you. Just like when, as I gave you an example, when you would go out from your country and go to another location, you will simply follow them and not the other way around. When it comes to Ramadan, because of frustration, many Muslims become agitated or try to become experts in astronomy. And they say, look, my brother is starting Ramadan this day. My uncle is starting Ramadan. What's going on? Why can't these mosques get together? Why can't these scholars get together? And so on and so forth. My sincere brothers and sisters in Islam, there's no reason for you to get frustrated. As I've been saying for 17 years, understand the problem. In Islam, all 12 months of the Islamic calendar depend on the moon sighting. It's really that simple. If you try to bring a system which is inconsistent or based on wrong science or based on wrong interpretation of the Quran and the Sunnah, you are going to create problems. Saudi Arabia started Sha'ban on the 25th of March. The moon, even if you don't believe in any science whatsoever, this moon was not sighted anywhere on the east of Saudi Arabia, whether it's Malaysia, Indonesia, Australia, New Zealand, or west of Saudi Arabia in Africa, in Europe, or Americas, all the way to California. Saudi Arabia stands alone. So because of this Ummul Qura based calendar of Sha'ban, they are going to start Ramadan one day early for the rest of the world. Countries around Saudi Arabia, whether it's UAE or Jordan or some other countries or even Egypt, they simply follow the declaration of Saudi Arabia. So if somebody tells you, yeah, my relatives live in Dubai and they started the same day as Saudi Arabia, it doesn't mean that they sighted the moon. They simply follow the declarations of each other. It is simple as that. What they do in that part of the world has no relevance on you living your life here in the West. They are robust, transparent, public systems of moon sighting in America, in Canada, in South America, in South Africa, in Zimbabwe, in Zambia, in United Kingdom, in Spain, in Italy, in France, and so on. It has no, you have no reason to import this sighting from other countries. You're creating a chaotic situation by importing this sighting, particularly when there is no 12 monthly system to follow. So I wanted to take a few minutes of my time to explain this to you. So understand that when you don't have a consistent system, you're going to have problems. So today is when I'm recording this, it is Thursday the 9th of April. I know that because yesterday was the 8th, the day before was the 7th. A week or so ago, March ended, so I knew March ended, April started. So in Islam, it says on the 29th at sunset time, go and try to sight the moon. If you don't know when exactly is the 29th of Sha'ban, you're going to create problems for Ramadan. If you don't know when is the 29th of Rajab, you're going to create problems for Sha'ban, and so on and so forth in the months before that. So starting from Muharram, Safar, Rabiul Awwal, Rabiul Thani, Jumadul Ula, Jumadul Thani, and so on. All of these months, Saudi Arabia makes no declaration. So they continue to follow this pre-calculated calendar. And some people say it is only for administrative purposes. It may be, but based on this calendar, they go on the 29th of the month and try to sight the moon even when they attempt it. So because there's no proper system, it's causing problems in the West. It's causing families to basically fall out with each other and so on and so forth. So all you need to do is if your mosque or your imam or your community leaders or elders in your community force the Saudi moon sighting system on you, go and ask them the question, how did you start the month of Rajab? Can you share the actual moon sighting information? So as I said, many sincere brothers and sisters, they become quite active in the month of Ramadan and they share moon sighting data from Saudi Arabia, sorry, moon sighting news from Saudi Arabia that this location sighted and that. Can you share that for Rajab? Can you share that for Rabiul Awwal? Can you share that for Rabiul Thani? So the question is then asked of you, how can you follow an inconsistent system? So I'm sorry to take a few minutes of your time, but I wanted to go out of my way to make you understand that basically, because it's an inconsistent system, if you want to fix the problem, then fix all 12 months and the problem will automatically go away. This Ummul Qura calendar is based on presence of the moon in the sky, not sighting. The moon can be present on the sky, it doesn't mean that you can see it. In the religion of Islam, all 12 months are based on sighting of the moon, and you can quite easily put formulas in place as to when the moon can be sighted. So if you use the correct science, then although you will not be following the sunnah, but the problem will go away. So Saudi Arabia, number one, doesn't have the right 12 monthly moon sighting system. Number two, does not follow the right science of astronomy. And I'm making it quite brief for you based on my 17 year experience in this issue. Moving on, when it comes to the month of Ramadan, the new moon is going to be born at 0327 on the 23rd of April. It is possible in Americas, which is South, Central, and North America, for this moon to be sighted if the conditions are perfect. So it is a possibility that they will start their Ramadan, the first Ramadan being the 24th of April. The rest of the countries, whether you are in Africa or parts of Asia or Australasia, this moon cannot be sighted. So you will complete 30 days of Sha'ban, and it is likely that your first of Ramadan will be on the 25th. Those countries which are having the 29th of Sha'ban on the 24th of April, this moon can be easily sighted in most parts of the world. So most parts of the world will have the first of Ramadan on the 25th of April, but Saudi Arabia guaranteed, because it's in the Ummul Qura calendar, they will finish 20, sorry, 30 days of Sha'ban. They will start Ramadan on the 24th of April, guaranteed, and there will be chaos and there will be two separate starts of Ramadan. Unfortunately. Why? Because I've explained to you, because a system has been implemented in their country, which they've never asked any Muslim outside of Saudi Arabia to follow. It is being imported and thrust upon the Muslims on the West, creating confusion and chaos and division. So all you've got to do is follow the Sunnah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, which says on the 29th, wherever you happen to live, go out and sight the moon. If you sight the moon, the new month starts. If you don't sight the moon, complete 30 days. It is simple as that. So our salvation, the solutions to our problems, are in following the Sunnah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.